So one type of tutorial which I always like to make is what we call a master detail tutorial, whereby you have a list of items with images and text, and then of course you click an item and then it opens for you a second page. This is what we're going to build right here. You can see as we download data from online, we show of course a progress bar, and at first you're not seeing any images, but the images are being loaded of course dynamically from online. You can see this is a very beautiful app. And then of course we have our list of images with card views, and then if you click a single item, for example I click this enterprise, it opens for us the detail page with the image, the name, the propellant, and more details which you can of course add. This is a master detail tutorial right here. Okay, so this is what we're going to build. You can see these are actually card views. Basically we have our list styles. In our list styles we have the card views, then of course we have this image, and then we have the name of the spacecraft, and then it's propellant. Okay, and then if you click any item, it opens for you, it passes those particular data into the detail page. So this is all we're going to look at right here. Okay, of course as we download data, the progress bar is actually going to get shown. In fact, if I come right here and then kill this application and then go back and then start it again, you're going to see of course you're showing a progress bar, a simple progress indicator, and very fast we load data. While loading our data, the images will be downloaded and cached dynamically. You can see them right here. Okay, so we can easily scroll through the items, and then whatever we click get passed. Okay, so it will get passed of course to the second activity. You can see the images are being loaded lazily. Okay, so the text first and then the images. So our application is actually becoming very, very fast and very responsive. You can easily scroll through the items. So this is it guys, this is what we're going to build right here in Flutter with that programming language. So this is in the portrait mode. Let's also look at this app. So of course as usual, we start by creating our Flutter application, then we come choose the Flutter application, click next, then come type your project name, then of course your SDK path, your project location, your description, then next, then of course you have your company domain, then click finish. So with that one ready, first let's come, we are interested in two files, main.dat, which is our main dat file, then the pubspec.yml. So this pubspec.yml is a configuration file. You can change the name of your app right here, its description as well. Then if suppose we had any dependencies, we just come and then type them right here below the Cupertino icons, and then click packages get. In this case we're not using any third party library. Okay, all classes you're using are actually inbuilt in this particular Flutter SDK. So let's come to main.dat. We're using the dat programming language right here to develop our Flutter application. This language syntactically it's quite similar to Java, you guys. If you're new, you're going to be surprised. For example, you can see that we have right here this one. Okay, this is how we import. We import using the import keyword. So for example, we're importing the dat.async because we'll be making asynchronous requests to the web to obtain of course our JSON information. Then of course we're also going to import material.dat. This one we're importing it from the Flutter SDK, then http.dat. Now we're going to import it also from our http, which is our dat, from our dat as a dat language, a standard library, and then import convert. Okay, so we have the convert, the http, material, and then the async. Now clearly you can see that once we've imported this http, we're going to use it as get. Okay, so as we are going to have written show get, and this is what we're going to be using. However, before we proceed further, I'd like us of course to see the JSON that we're going to show. Okay, let's go open up our browser and actually view the JSON data which you're going to be working with. All right, so this is the JSON data we're working with. You can see it's actually hosted publicly. I've hosted it publicly, of course, in GitHub, so you guys can also have access to it. Now it will give us the ID, the name, the propellant, destination, image URL, and then whether the technology exists. So we're going to show both images and text right here, okay? So this is the URL right here, okay? We're going to see this particular data, okay? We'll be able to work with this data we're going to be working with. So let's proceed over. So we come, of course, once we've made these imports, then that is an object-oriented, a pure object-oriented language, meaning that everything in that is an object, okay? All variables you're going to work with, including the primitive types, are actually reference types like objects, like integers, doubles, etc. Okay, so we come first. For example, we create this class which we call the spacecraft. The spacecraft, this will have these properties: an ID, name, image URL, and propellant. All of them are strings. Okay, this is how we have them as our JSON data. Then our constructor will take this for this dot ID, this dot name, this dot image URL. So in that, what we are doing right here, we'll receive an ID, okay, a spacecraft object. Now this spacecraft object will have the ID, the name, image URL, and propellant, and automatically we're going to assign them right here, okay? So implicitly they will be assigned as long as we mark them with this keyword. Then we're going to have this factory constructor, okay? Then we invoke the from JSON. Now we're going to receive a JSON data, okay? So we come, we have this particular map which will represent our JSON data. Then this is what we're going to return. We're going to return a spacecraft object with the ID. Remember, this is our ID, okay? We obtain the JSON from our JSON data. We obtain the ID part and then assign it to this ID. We obtain the name and then assign it to the name. Obtain propellant, assign it to propellant. Obtain image URL, assign it to image URL. And then we return a spacecraft object. Remember, our constructor is meant to take these properties, okay? So we're going to then return an instance of this particular spacecraft and then return it. Then we'll have this class which we call custom list view. Now, as you guys can see, it's going to be extending the stateless widget. So first and foremost, we're going to have, given that it's a stateless widget, its variables, actually its instance fields, have to be final. So we mark them as final. So final list of spacecrafts, which we call spacecrafts right here. Then of course we'll have one constructor. This constructor will retrieve, take of course our spacecrafts list, and then assign it right here. Then of course we'll have this particular build method. Now the build method is what will build this particular custom list view and then return it as a widget, our stateless widget. It's a method overriding. So we come right here, we're going to return a list view dot builder, meaning that we'll be building a list view and returning it. So how many items are we going to have in our list view? Well, we assign the number in this item count property. Now we're going to have the spacecrafts dot length, okay? So we obtain the number of spacecrafts we have and use it as the item count. So our list view therefore is going to be it's not going to know, of course, the number of items it will be able to display in advance. Instead, it will display all the items that we have in our JSON data. Then, of course, we'll come here and have our item builder. This is what is going to allow us to construct our view item. So all we need to do is to just return a view item. So we invoke the create view item and then we pass in two properties. First, we need to pass in a build context, and then we also need to pass in our spacecrafts, the current spacecraft. So we'll use this index to obtain the current spacecraft, and then we'll pass it to the view item. So create view item is a method which we're going to create. Let's come create it. So as you can see, it will be returning a widget. It's taking in the spacecraft object as well as a build context object. What are we returning? Well, we're returning a list style, okay? So return new list style. this new style will have as its title a card view. Okay, so new card, then the elevation for the card is going to be 5 dp. Then the card will have a child which we call a container, which is also a widget. This widget will have a decoration of a box decoration with, of course, orange border. Okay, so the border is going to be orange. That is going to wrap everything inside the container. Then these are the padding as well as the margin for our container. The container will have a single child called a column. This column will have a multitude of children widgets right here. So we specify them using an array. Then we're going to have a padding. The first child of our column will be a padding. Now this padding right here, of course, as this child, it will have an image. Now this image is image which we're going to load from the network. This is very important. So we invoke the image class and then invoke its network method. Then we just pass in the image URL, and that's it. This will load for us our image, okay, from the network, and then show it in an image view. So take note that this is actually going to, the image will be loaded lazily, okay, in the background thread and lazily, meaning that this image is not going to, the text will be, you'll see the text being shown first before the images are loaded, and within a short while the images are also going to get loaded right here. Okay, so we have right here child image.network, and that's it as our first padding. Then below the image we're going to have, of course, a row of children. So these are going to be widget objects, of course. So we come right here, we're going to have a padding. Now in this padding, of course, its child is a text. Now of course, what will this text show is going to show the name of the spacecraft. So we pass it right there. Then we assign the style, text style, as well as the text alignment. Then of course we provide it also with a padding. Then we also have another text below this padding. This is just going to show this separator for us. And then next to it, we're going to have, of course, a text which will show for us the propellant. So basically, we're having a row of widgets, first to show our name, and then to show the separator, and then to show the propellant. We're showing them in a single row. So that's what we're going to do, okay? Take note, spacecraft.propellant will obtain for us the propellant for that spacecraft. Okay, so once you've done that one, then just outside the card and still within the list style, we're going to have the onTap. So this is a method, this property right here, we're going to assign it, of course, a method which is going to be handled for us, our callback, okay? The method which will be called when the user taps a single list tile. So we come right here, and what are you going to do? First, you're going to create a page router, okay? So var route equal to new material page route. Now, then builder, this is going to allow us, of course, to replace the entire screen with the second page, okay? Because we want that if the user clicks a single item, then we need to move the user to that next page. So we come right here, we assign it a builder. Then in our builder, we're going to pass it, of course, a second screen. So new second screen, then of course value is going to be the spacecraft, that spacecraft object, okay, the current spacecraft object. Then of course we come right here, we use the navigator of to push that particular route, of course, in our stack of routes, okay? So basically this will push it or open for us the second screen. So navigator.of, then push, then we push the route. Then of course, having done that one, let's now come right here, just outside any outside that particular build class, but still within our custom list view, we're going to have this method which we are calling the, not inside the class but outside any class, okay? We'll have this method called the download JSON. We're going to download our JSON data asynchronously, and then we're going to return a future object of generic type list of spacecrafts. So this future rate is an object that will represent for us a delayed computation. So we come right here, This will actually make our download to take place in the background thread. The advantage of this one is that the application is not going to be blocked, so it's going to be smooth and fast. Okay, the user can still use the app as the data gets downloaded. But first we have to specify the JSON endpoint. This is the URL from which we'll be downloading our JSON data. So we come here and specify our JSON endpoint. As you can see, we're fetching it from GitHub. Then we come and specify the response. Okay, in fact, this response right here, we are performing an HTTP GET request, and then once the data is ready, is when we'll assign it to this response object. So await. Okay, this will make our data to be fetched, and then only when it's ready will it be assigned to this particular response. So await GET. So where is this GET coming from? Actually, you can replace this GET with http.get. Remember, we had actually imported this http.dat. This is a library, so it will give us the HTTP class, and we can actually invoke its GET method. So you can either type right there http.get here, or just type GET. Suppose we added this one, show GET right here. Okay, yeah, so that's what we're doing. Then we pass in the JSON endpoint from which you want to download our data. When the response is ready, we're going to check the status code. So the status code, this HTTP request normally return for us as status codes. Okay, so you check the status code of the response, and that status code can actually tell you something about that particular request which you've made. For example, if the status code is 200, normally that this actually stands for the HTTP OK. So HTTP OK means that that response was successful. For example, if you find a status code of 404 normally means you may have already encountered it while browsing websites. It means that the resource which you are looking for is actually not found, is a not found response. So in our case, we're only interested in 200 to indicate that our request was actually successful. So if that is the case, then what are we going to do? Remember, our response body is going to be our JSON data. So we're going to decode that JSON data using the JSON.decode class. Okay, JSON.decode. Then JSON.decode method, we pass in our response body, is going to decode it, of course, according to our spacecraft objects, and then we assign it to this particular list. Then we return those spacecrafts. Having done that one, we're then going to, in fact, map the spacecrafts right here, spacecrafts.map. Then we're going to come right here, new spacecraft.from.json, then to list. Okay, so this will map the list of objects which you're going to maintain. It will map it, of course, into a list of spacecrafts, okay, which are actually generic. So we come and listen to the else part of the if condition. So if the response code is not equal to 200, then of course we're going to throw an exception. We'll tell the user that we're not able to successfully download the JSON data. Then of course we'll come and construct our second screen. This is our second page. We're going to make it extend the stateful widget. A stateful widget is a widget that of course has a state, and a state basically is the internal information of a given widget. So this second screen will have some internal information. Among them, of course, is going to be this particular spacecraft, which is our instance field. This is a value, okay? Spacecraft as a value, it will have a spacecraft object. This is the object which we're going to be receiving from the first screen. So if you click a single card in our master page, then we're going to pass an object to the second screen, and then hold that particular object as this particular value. Okay, now how are we going to receive the object? Well, just via the constructor. So this is the constructor for the second screen. You can see it's receiving a key as well as a value. So of course, the key, we don't have to explicitly specify it, because the key is actually the identifier for this particular screen. So this dot value is going to be, of course, our the spacecraft. Okay, so this dot value return our spacecraft, will receive it, and then the key will be passed, of course, to the superclass, which is our stateful widget. Now, given that this is a stateful widget, we have to override the create state. This is the method that is will actually create the state and return it. So which state will we be creating? A state which we call the second screen state. Now, second screen state, let's come create it. Of course, it has to extend the state class. The state class will have to be of generic type second screen. Now, the states normally also have a build method which will build and then return the widget for which that particular state is being created. So in this case, of course, our widget, let's come right here. Then we're going to return a scaffold. Now this scaffold will allow us, of course, to construct a basic material design page. So return new scaffold. Then first that page will have an app bar with the title, which we call the detail page. Then of course it will have a body. So the body, at the root, we're going to have a container. Inside the container will have a center. Inside the center will have a column. Now in Flutter, actually all these three, center, column, and container, these are also widgets. Okay, however, they're not visible. They are the type of widgets which we use to arrange items. The column will have an array of widgets. We come right and specify them. The first of them will be a padding. The padding, of course, will have this particular text which will show for us the spacecraft details. This is basically the title or the header on the top of the page. Okay, then of course below that padding will have another padding. This padding, this time round, will show for us the image. So child image dot network, then we supply, of course, we obtain the image URL. So take note right here of widget dot value dot image URL, obtaining it from the widget. Now, where are we getting this widget? Well, this widget basically will represent, of course, the widget for this particular state, which is our second screen. Okay, so the second screen will obtain its value right here, which will receive the constructor, and then we invoke the image URL. Now, having done that one, will then come this, of course, will load our image again, and then we're going to supply, of course, a padding for the bottom. Then below them we'll also specify another padding also with the text. This time round we're going to show the name. Okay, and then lastly we'll have another padding, and this time round we'll show the propellant for the spacecraft. So these guys, we've actually created a simple master detail application, okay, with two screens, master screen as well as the detail screen. Now let's now come and create a class, which is what we call our main class. This is what will represent our full application. So class my app extends stateless widget. Here we're going to vary the build method. So this build method, as you can see, is receiving a build context. Now of course, first and foremost, we're going to return a widget, and the widget we're returning is a material app. Now this material app will have this theme. These are primary color. Okay, so we assign it right here, the primary color, using this primary search right here, and then we come and then assign, passing the home. So the home, of course, we're again going to construct a basic page using the scaffold class. So inside the scaffold constructor, we'll pass in the app bar. So app bar equal to new app bar, then we pass in the title for the app. Then of course we're going to specify the body for the app. So new center. Now this center widget will arrange our widgets, of course, to the center of the screen. Then of course we're going to, as a child, we're going to pass in as a future builder object. Okay, so future builder, as you can see, is a widget that will build itself based on the latest snapshot of interaction with the future. Now remember, our data is going to be coming from online, and we said that of course we're going to be returning a future object. Okay, this future object will be we'll have a generic type of list of objects. So this feature builder right here will allow us to successfully work with, of course, our future object which we'll be receiving, because remember that future object is actually representing a delayed computation. We're not yet, well, of course, this code is going to be executed. At first, our data is not going to be ready. Our future object will not yet have been returned, because we said this future represents a delayed computation. So this future builder actually understands that one, and therefore we can actually successfully work with it. However, we'll have to pass into its constructor the future object which will be returned. Where are we getting that future object? Well, by just invoking the download JSON. This will download JSON data and then return a future object. Okay, and that's what the future builder will work with. Then of course we'll pass in, of course, to in our builder, we'll pass in of course a build context as well as an async snapshot. Okay, so once we've passed those two right here, we're going to come, all right, so within our builder, first we're going to check if our snapshot actually has data. This snapshot, as you can see, is an async snapshot object, so we check if it has any data, then we're going to obtain that data and assign it to our list of spacecrafts. Then we return a custom list view and we pass that particular list of spacecraft into our custom list view constructor. Now if our snapshot has an error, what are we going to do? We're going to show that error. Okay, now otherwise we come right here and proceed. Now meanwhile, we're going to be returning a circular progress indicator, because we'll be showing a progress bar. Okay, we'll be showing a progress indicator as we download our data. So that's what we're going to do right here. Okay, so just add this code right here within our builder, and then lastly we'll come below right here and paste this code main and then run app. Okay, and then we pass in an instance of my app. This is our main method, is the entry point to our application. So guys, this is it, this is what we need. Okay, so main app, then run app, then you pass an instance of our my app. Okay, so this is all the code that you guys need to make, of course, a master detail application with JSON data and a customer's view with images and text. Okay, not very hard, but you can see in Flutter is actually very convenient, because you're going to paste this source code in our website, so you guys can just, all you need to do is to go copy it and then paste it, and that's it. You will not need to make any changes. Okay, if you don't want to, we're not using any third party library, we're not using anything, there's no configuration needed. Just go copy this source code from our website and paste it, and that's it. That's all you need to do, and build the APK, and then you'll be able to see your application working. Okay, so this is all we need to do, guys. Make sure you guys like this video, share it. If of course you love our channel, then you want to make sure you subscribe and also help us spread the word. Otherwise, you can provide for us more recommendations on tutorials you want us to do, and of course like the video, share it, and make sure you subscribe, and take care. I'll catch you in the next class.